Singer-songwriter Andy Grammer there with Don't Give Up On Me. His latest release is a lot more than a number one hit. With honest, simple lyrics building to a stirring crescendo, it's the kind of song that can bring either a flood of tears or feelings of hope, and probably both. Don't Give Up On Me was written for the movie 5 Feet Apart, a teen romance sick flick released earlier this year about two teenagers suffering from cystic fibrosis, a disease which rarely gets the spotlight in pop culture. In order to prevent cross-infection, CF patients must remain at least 6 feet away from one another.
God, you're beautiful. You're brave. Wish I could touch you.
Stay away.
6 feet at all times. I got it.
Catches infection and you can kiss new lungs goodbye.
And it's that rule which separates the movie's two lead characters until they decide to reclaim at least part of their lives back from the disease, and they breach the medical guidelines by just 1 foot. And so we have the name of the movie, 5 Feet Apart. And now we have Andy Grammer joining us from Los Angeles for more on this. How many times did you cry watching that movie?
Oh, it's a brutal movie, man. It'll get you. If you go see, you know, it was directed by one of my good friends, so I watched the screeners, then we went to the premiere, and then because a lot of the proceeds of my song, which are so tightly associated with the movie, we donated the proceeds to Claire's Place Foundation, which is a foundation that helps patients with cystic fibrosis. So they had their own events. I've seen this movie many times. I've cried many, many times in this movie. It's fantastic. Everyone should go ugly cry to it.
Absolutely. And I should say thank you for being with us, because it's been a while since we've had you in. So thank you for joining us here.
Thanks, man.
It is a tearjerker. And you know, the movie and your song really complement each other. It's this kind of hopeful message. Firstly, don't give up on yourself. And you know, life is there to be lived, making the most of every day.
Yeah. It's been amazing reactions to it from the movie, and then also outside of the movie. It's just this song has taken on a life of its own, and there's like all these videos of cancer patients leaving their treatment, singing "I'm not giving up." There's like videos of kids singing it, like full classrooms of children singing the song, which makes it hit home a little bit more. I just, in general, love when music can push you a little further. Like, everybody has so much to give, and if this song does its job, it's supposed to just be like, keep pushing, you can do it.
And the inspiration, you touched on this, a young woman called Claire Wineland, who suffered from cystic fibrosis. Claire passed away last September. She was 21 years old. She lived an incredible life. And you know, we should note that, as she said, you know, the part of the proceedings from Don't Give Up are heading to Claire's Place. This is a foundation named in her honor, which helps families who are affected by CF. But beyond that, you know, when I went online, I saw, you know, a lot of YouTube clips where people had used the song and put their own personal photos, their own personal stories to your music. Or there were stories in the newspaper about people who, you know, who come to the end of their lives, they dealt with some terrible medical condition, but they found comfort in listening to your music. You know, for any artist, that feeling, knowing that your song is making such a direct difference in a person's life, must be the ultimate sort of feeling of satisfaction, of gratitude, and of accomplishment.
It's amazing. It's truly unbelievable to be a part of a song like this. And you know, I've had songs that have given me comfort when I really needed it. And that was one of my goals when writing this. There's a place when things are all, when it's all going so hard, that you can always go to, which is like, no matter what, I'm still gonna fight to the end. And to see so many people relating to it and using this song to pull up that emotion themselves, it's the best. It's the dream. I'm so lucky and blessed to be a part of this one.
Let's stick with the feel-good stuff here, okay? Because we don't get that all that often. Don't give up on me. You performed this with the kids from New York's Public School 22, a group of fourth and fifth graders from Staten Island. Here's a clip.
Yeah.
A couple of tears right there at the end.
Man, that's the fourth take, because I didn't know how good they were going to be, And to hear elementary school kids singing Don't Give Up On Me, it caught me off guard. We had, that was the fourth take. The first three times, I'm just crying the whole time like a joke. It was so sweet. Gosh, they were incredible.
Yeah, these kids just come from this sort of diverse background, mostly from families who are economic challenged, but they put together this incredible choir.
It's unbelievable. The harmonies were amazing, and there was so much sincere emotion. It caught me off guard. Yeah. And I think it caught a lot of us off guard. It was really good.
It's amazing what this song is doing. The last time, though, we spoke, it was about another song, Fresh Eyes. It had just come out. Here's a reminder.
Suddenly, I'm in love with a stranger. I can't believe she's mine. Now all I see is you, fresh eyes, fresh eyes.
It started out as a love song that you'd wrote for your wife, and then you decided to use it to highlight homelessness in Los Angeles. And here's part of our conversation back then. Listen to this.
I know this video is not going to make a huge dent in homelessness by any means. We are raising money. If you watch the end of the video, where it goes to the Union Rescue Mission in Los Angeles, which is doing incredible stuff. But what I wanted to do more than anything was just raise some compassion. If someone saw this video and then they go about their day and they pass someone who's homeless and take an extra look and maybe say hi and maybe give them something or just start up a conversation with them and be able to break through this film that our society has of who those people are, then it would be successful.
You know, sadly, the latest numbers, though, from Los Angeles show that the homeless population, it's gone up 12% over last year, more than 58,000 people living on the streets in L.A. County. It's the largest unsheltered population in the United States. No one expected you to solve homelessness. This is a huge problem which only really governments can fix. But how do you explain the disconnect between, homeless people and the rest of us?
I think it's one of those things that's just far too easy to disassociate from. And I might have been someone who did that as well. It's just that I spent 4 years of my early career street performing. And someone that was next to me suffering from homelessness wasn't some person that was like off in the periphery. They were Dave, and they were like someone I would talk to.
Yeah.
And we'd like hang out. And that helped, personally helped me see it a lot closer and just care way more about it. And the numbers have gone up. And I think, going back to Don't Give Up On Me, that is no reason, even though it seems like an insurmountable task, there's still something that we can all do. Even if it's just being aware of it, getting involved in your community. Yeah. And the guy that I made this, the song is in Justin Baldoni's movie, right? 5 Feet Apart. And he started something called the Skid Row Carnival, which once a year gives so much money, funds, different things to the homeless population down in Skid Row. And it's amazing to be a part of. And the more that you're around people that are being of service and taking action, the less hopeless you feel about it.
Yeah, that's a great point. You've been doing a lot of things since we last spoke, and I want to finish up with your podcast because you have some very big names sharing some of their stories and their beliefs. And there's been this one question which you've repeatedly asked, which is, what do you think happens? Where do you think we go after we die? So I'll put the question
I love
to
this
you.
Question.
What happens after we die?
First of all, I love this question because I think it plays a big deal in how you live now, depending on what you think happens when we pass away. I was taught, I'm a Baha'i, I was raised a member of the Baha'i faith, and I was taught that it's much like the womb. So you're like in the womb and you're growing and then you come out into this new amazing place. And you're growing in the womb and you don't even know why you're growing arms and legs, but you need them once you get here. And I think that we're here to grow spiritually, and then whatever the next place is, I think is pretty incredible. I love this question because there's no perfect right answer, and anyone that answers it, it gets really, really interesting. So if you think, if the answer is like, nope, lights out, dead, done, full black, that's amazing and fascinating. And if you think like I think that you go somewhere, super fascinating. It's just a great, great question to get people out of their comfort zones. I think we're a little too tight-lipped right now about some of the biggest questions about being alive. So that's what my podcast, The Good Parts Podcast, it brings people on and we air it out for like an hour on what their take is on what's their most spiritual experience, what do you think happens when we die, what's the best and worst thing about money. These big, big questions that I think people are just a little bit afraid to talk about right now. I'm not sure why.
It's because there is so much happening right now. It is so difficult to digest and to keep track of everything. There almost doesn't seem any time for, you know, those big issues. But, you know, I've been wondering where the good guys are. You're one of them. I'm glad you've shared your story with us, Andy. So good to see you.
Thank you for having me, man. What a great time. I appreciate it.
Pleasure. Thank you for watching CNN Newsroom. I'm John Vores. Please stay with us. Rosemary Church is up after this short break. You're watching CNN.